Hi, it's Mark from Top Local Lead Generation. We're here with David Fairbairn of FairbairnInspections.com in Vancouver. And you can reach him at 604-395-2795. Today, we're talking about the gross stuff. We're talking about mold. So, how are you doing today, David?
I'm doing pretty good, Mark. Mold's not that gross. If you like blue cheese or... I'm trying to think of some other examples. You know, mold is actually pretty... If you like beer, mold is pretty good.
Penicillin?
You know, yeah, penicillin. If you like not getting sick, you know, mold is pretty helpful. So it is gross and in some cases helpful. And yeah, I would like to show you today what mold looks like. Have you seen a lot of mold?
Unfortunately, I have.
Okay. Excellent. Yeah, so I've got some photos for you. So what I'd like to do is... load up on the screen a picture. I'm going to share this in just a moment here. There we go. Can you see that, Mark?
Yep.
Okay, so we're talking about what mold looks like. Now, this is probably one of my top questions when it comes to mold-related questions. Somebody standing there and looking at something going, I think that might be mold. You know, I can't tell. So... what I want to start with is that it's very important to note you can't tell if something is mold or not just by looking at it. You can know what mold usually looks like, and you can know different growth patterns, but if you're not sure, what you should do is sample it. Take a sample of the material and take it to a lab for testing, because they're actually going to be able to tell you if it's mold or not. And even myself, you know, doing mold for years, you know, I've done testing and sampling and investigations, and there's still some cases where we find mold where it doesn't look like mold or it doesn't look like anything. So what I'd like to do is sort of show you how mold grows, and this will give you a better idea about what it, you know, sort of how it appears and what it might look like. So what we're looking at right now is a microscope slide of some mold. So what we've got here is... the structure of mold, and you can see that it's not just you know, a blob of slime. It's actually quite defined, and that's because mold is a plant, right? It's part of the it's part of the fungus family, right? So when you have mold, you actually have fungus, and you know, mushrooms, those are fungus. So there's different types of fungus, and mold, of course, is a type of that. So it grows just like any plant, and you know,
David,
if you look at it up close. Yeah,
David, you need to turn on your full screen.
Is it not on full screen?
Not yet, no.
Oh, okay, hang on a second. I'm going to pull that up here.
I know this first part isn't all that important, but later it becomes...
How about this? See that? Is that full screen?
It's loading. Just thinking about it. Google's wonders.
Yeah, sorry, we're getting some technical difficulties here. I'm going to try that one more time, Mark. Let's see if the screen share works. And if you are enjoying today's episode, go to google.com, go to Hangouts, and tell them what you think of their program.
It's a great program when it works.
When it works, yeah.
And unfortunately, it sets the expectation it's always going to work because it's so good when it works.
You know, Google's motto is, we're not happy till you're not happy. How's that? Is that good?
There we go.
Okay. Can you see the
slide,
the mold in all its glory? Okay.
Yep.
So what we're looking at here is the structure of the mold. And you'll notice it has sort of branches, just like a tree or a plant. And then you've got these tips here where that you have the spore production, the circles. Okay. So if we look at what that actually is, we're looking at what's called mycelium. Mycelium is the structure of the mold. It's all the branches woven together. And the branches are called hyphae, or hypha individually. So this is how it spreads and grows. And once mold sets up, it takes about 24 to 48 hours to grow in material. And after a certain amount of time, usually 10 to 14 days, it's ready to reproduce. So the mold decides to release some spores into the air, and hopefully those spores settle and grow more mold. So when you hear about respiratory problems, people getting sick from mold, it's the spores we're talking about. It's not the actual mold material. It's actually the spores that are floating around the air, and you're breathing them in, because some spores are toxic. Okay, so that's the idea behind the growth. If we look at it here, it's eating away at this bread. So you've probably seen bread mold before. It usually doesn't look this extreme, but this is just sort of for illustration. We can see that the mold here has taken root. It's feeding off the material. Mold will grow in any organic material if the conditions are right. So if it's warm and wet, it usually thrives. And at one point or another, we get spore production. And this one's actually in full spore production mode. So we're looking at an attic now, Mark. So this is actually a fairly new construction building. This house was only... Do you want to guess how old this attic is?
From the state of the OSB and some of the other clues I can see there, it's probably no more than 10 years old.
Yeah, it's actually 1.5. So I want to, just as an aside, we perform home inspections. You should always get, even if your house is 1.5 years old, get it inspected every single time. So this attic, 1.5 years old, terrible ventilation problems, and they're also using OSB, which stands for oriented strand board, which is basically replaced plywood in most new construction. And you can see it's sort of made out of wood chips. It's also a great surface for mold to grow on. I would, conservatively say it's about 150% more likely to grow mold than plywood or wood itself. So you have to be very careful with this material. And what we've got here is you can see the blotches. As you move up to the center of the screen, you can see sort of black blotches forming everywhere. And this is the same attic here, and we've got this growth pattern. And as the blotches form, they start connecting together. So what we've got is it's mostly black. In some areas, it's actually white. And in some areas, it can actually turn blue. So mold can look like any of those and still be part of the same family of mold. So it's very important to get it tested, because you won't be able to tell what type of material it is until you actually get it tested. Any idea what happened here, Mark? You want to hazard a guess? This is an attic as well.
Leaking the roof?
Leaking the roof. This is actually a marijuana grow operation.
From downstairs.
Leak from downstairs, exactly. So marijuana grow operations are very damaging, particularly to attics. And here the moisture was so high that the entire attic was just covered in a web of mold. Now, this is actually post-remediation. So they'd actually gone through and cleaned all the mold out, and this is what was left over the staining. So you can imagine how bad it was before this. This was a type of mold called Penicillin, which is related to penicillin. And it is, it can be harmful. This is something you don't want to play around with, especially if you see it at this level. This is the same house, so we're looking at a grow operation where they had removed the growth. And this is after thousands and thousands of dollars of removal. So you can imagine how thick that must have been before to take root that deeply, that they weren't even able to get the lines out of the wood. Nails are rusted. They had a huge, huge amount of moisture going up into the attic. So that's something we can see. So that's what mold looks like. What you should do is, there's two tests we offer. We can do sampling, so we can come in and actually test the mold stain to see if it actually is mold and if it's alive or not. And we can actually do an air quality test, which is where we sample the air in the home and provide you with results of how many spores are floating around. So we have some different equipment to do that. This is our This is a Zephon bio pump. This is some of the equipment we're using. This actually sucks air through the top. That white disc at the top is called a spore trap. And it will capture the spores floating around in the air. And we break it open and we put it on a microscope. And we can tell if there's any indoor air quality issues. Okay, so if you have something that looks like mold or you're not sure, play it safe and get it tested. You can call us at 604-395-2795 and we can come out. We can determine if you have a mold problem, where it's coming from, and what to do about it.
Awesome. So I think we'll, I don't know if there's anything more to say.
Yeah, you know, mold can look like a lot of things. It can be fuzzy. It can be, you know, black webbing like that. And as we go along, you know, in our next episode, I'll sort of bring some new shots of some different things we found in homes, everywhere from, you know, a wall that looked completely bare and it actually had mold on it, up to a room that was basically falling apart. And, you know, we've got some really good stuff coming up, so stay tuned.
Awesome. So we've been talking with building inspector, home inspector, and mold specialist, Mr. David Fairbairn, Fairbairn Inspections in Vancouver. Reach him at fairbairninspections.com. Tons of great information on the site. Or you can give him a call, 604-395-2795. Thanks, David.
Thanks, Mark. Talk to you later.
Bye.